Hello everyone, hope you all are doing well. So today's video is about how to prepare your ENT, and it is one requested video. See, it is a small subject, so mind you, ENT and ophthal, as they are for limited marks and limited portion constraint, you might you have to expect to get a tougher paper instead, because they might try not to repeat the similar questions. You know, some part of the paper does have repeated questions, but some part of it doesn't. You know, either your ENT or ophthal is a bomb, okay? So make sure that you actually do not miss out on some points that I would tell right now. Apart from the important questions that you go through your guidebooks, this is something that I want you to, you know, have a look, you know, when you go through the topic. So this is for that, and for all the toppers that are waiting for a gold medal in ENT, these are some points that you have to not miss on, okay? They are something you would overlook or something that you would read yet not remember. So this is something you have to stress on, and let's get into the video, okay? First things first, anatomy anywhere, like in your ear and nasal, paranasal sinus, your larynx, everything is very important, okay? Make sure that you are clear with anatomy. We tend to overlook the anatomy part, but no, it is important that you actually gain clarity in your middle ear and inner ear anatomy, okay? Middle ear, especially the facial nerve relation, its branch is very important. When you are reading the anatomy simultaneously, you need to correlate with cholesteatoma, theories of cholesteatoma. Once you're done with that, read about the facial nerve, because you have read the middle ear thoroughly. So facial nerve, reading it right now would be beneficial, because you have to read the entire course of facial nerve, its relation with the middle ear cavity, and then the potential sites of facial nerve injury, transverse and longitudinal fracture differences in the facial nerve context. You have to read all of it, okay? Make sure facial nerve is something that would never leave you. Even you, when you get your final year, facial nerve will never leave you, okay? With respect to your pulse palsy or something, still you have to read your facial nerve, and they do ask the facial nerve course in your viva. After you're done with that, audiometry is something I feel is one tough topic, but yes, you can get through it, okay? One such thing where you should not miss is the hearing test, under which you have Jelly's test, Jell's test and a Schwaback's test, okay? I did my homework here, so I would be quickly going through without wasting much time, okay? And then we have tympanograms. All of the tympanograms, make sure you read that. See, whenever you get a question like otosclerosis or tympanic perforation or anything, make sure that irrespective of which part of the textbook it is, if you know that, you know, you read tympanogram, you get a question about menias or otosclerosis, you can yet draw a tympanogram there, na? You can draw and represent it. That is how you correlate it, and that is what people expect. And you do that, you get an edge over the marks. So that is how I did. And you have to read Bera, CC, presbycusis. Once you're done with the audiogram, you have to go to the end of the ENT session. Not ENT, ear session. Okay, where you have rehabilitation devices in a deaf child, where you read about that is a bone-anchored hearing aid. Very important. And apart from that, your rehabilitation devices for the deaf child is important. Then we go to menias, one of the most favorite questions of everyone. And in that, you should not miss about tibial phenomenon and diplocusis. You have many phenomenon in many parts of the diseases in ear and all of it. Now, when you're reading it under menias, it seems fine. But once you reach the end of the book, you get a question on this, and that is where confusion starts. So make sure you actually pen down such phenomenon on a sheet and just go through it, you know, at least on the last minute of giving your exam before going. I suggest you do that, because in order to end your confusion, it would actually be helpful, because you might end up getting a 2-mark question for sure, for sure. And in otosclerosis, you have a Vanderhoof syndrome. Do not just miss that shot. And then neuromas, acoustic neuroma. See, cancers anywhere are important with respect to any subject, okay? So do not think that this might not be important. We weren't given any question on this previously, but you should at least go through it, you know, superficially. Okay, and in this you have a histal burger sign, that is loss of sensation in the posterior aspect of the ear, posterior superior aspect of the ear. That is important. It's a 2-mark 1. Then I forgot to tell one thing. There's a congenital abnormality called Mondini's dysplasia, which is just 1.75 turns of cochlea. That is a question. Then we have malignant otitis externa. Why is this important? Because it is only seen in diabetics, immunocompromised, and the organism here is Pseudomonas. So mostly it is, we have strep pneumonia and all of it, but here it is a Pseudomonas. That is the reason this is given a specific importance. Okay, then you shouldn't miss on simple things like swimmer's ear, boxer's ear, surfer's ear. Okay, then we have CSOM, ASOM, you read anyways. Okay, and you will get an ear polyp, CSOM cases in your final long case. Okay, and under surgeries, you have to read the canal wall up, wall down surgery, inlay, outlay procedures, all of it. Okay, if you are someone who wants to aim for a gold medal, and people who cannot understand what is this canal wall up and wall down procedures, just let me know in the comment section below so that I can make a simpler, crisp video on how to understand the surgeries of CSOM. Okay, and under complication, lateral sinus thrombosis, may you have things like, you know, signs, Tobi-Ayer sign, Kroebeck sign, they are important, MT-Delta sign, important, potential tumor questions, okay, tympanoplasties are important, and then under petrositis, you have this triad called Gradenigo's triad, which is a 5th-6th nerve involvement along with ear discharge. So this is a question as well, okay, and that is it. You have to read about simple things like tinnitus, calories test, Dundas air test, which is done if the eardrum is perforated. And then you have VPPV, benign paroxysmal positional vertigo. You have to read that. And then you are done with ear. Okay. Then you have larynx. Obviously, cancer of larynx is important. And then we have things like Bloom-Singer prosthesis. What is an esophageal speech? Papillomas of larynx, vocal cord palsy is the essence of larynx chapter. Okay, firstly you have to read about the course of what is this external laryngeal, internal laryngeal, what is the innervation, what will happen if each of it is paralyzed, and then you read about vocal cord palsy, what is adduction, abduction, what, which nerve aids in which thing, then you are done. You'd be a pro. It is difficult, but yet you can do that, you know, just keep revising, and diagrammatic representation would actually help. Then you read about Siemens law, and then you read about the cross section of the vocal cord. Vocal cord cross section, there will be an image in your book, so make sure you read that. And then we have epiglottitis versus a croup. Epiglottitis, croup. Thumb sign, steeple sign. Epiglottitis is an emergency. E for E, emergency, always in an ICU setting. Whereas croup is not an emergency. So there's only some hoarseness of voice seen. Whereas a dysphagia is seen in epiglottitis. So epiglottitis and croup, 2-mark questions or a 4-mark. It's very important. Then we have pharynx. Under pharynx, you have to read about the pharyngeal spaces, okay, the retropharyngeal space, prevertebral space, and pharyngeal membrane. Okay, sorry. Yeah, pharyngobasilar membrane, that is. And you have to read about the abscess, pharyngeal abscess, Ludwig's abscess, and tonsils, as you know, important. And tonsils is a definite long case in your examination. So for your viva as well, you need to go through tonsils and surgeries in tonsils, especially the chronic tonsillitis and complications of tonsillitis surgery, very important. So just go through it. And nasopharyngeal cancer, what is a Passavant's ridge, Zenker's diverticulum, Quinacy, pharyngitis, adenoids, you know, JNA is an essay. We had an essay, juvenile nasopharyngeal angiofibroma. So do not forget that. Under esophagus, you have to read about achalasia, the X-ray features, rat tail sign, bird beak appearance of X-rays, important. And then you have oral cavity. In that, you need to read a submucosal fibrosis, very important. And then you have erythroplakia, leukoplakia, ranula, and tongue tie, that is ankyloglossia, and aphthous ulcers, very important. Okay. And nothing great about oral ulcers. Oral cancers are more important when you get on to your surgery next, prof. But right now, it is not of much. Next, under nose, do not miss rhinoscleroma and rhinosperidiosis. You would anyways be reading about the nasal anatomy, you know, the DNS surgeries, sinusitis and all of it. But I want to tell you something which you would actually miss. Okay. And what is lupus vulgaris? Lupus vulgaris is the TB of the nose face. Okay. And apple jelly nodules are seen in lupus vulgaris. Very important. And then polyps, epistaxis, you know all of it. Paranasal sinus anatomy, do not give it a miss. Do not take a chance. Read that. And then under benign and neoplasms, benign and malignant neoplasm of nasal cavity, you have inverted papilloma, also called a Ringer's tumor or Schneiderian papilloma. Why is it important? See, normally any tumor is exophytic, that means it grows outward. But this one, inverted papilloma, is something which grows inward into the stroma. That is the only reason this has some importance here in the book. So, do not miss, we had a question on this. So, that is all you need to know about your ENT. So, I hope it covers all of your doubts. So, these are something that you should not give a miss. Don't know how the paper might turn. If you have any doubts, just leave in the comment section below. Thank you for watching.